If you are one of my 89,000 subscribers watching me, you know I don't like most of the books I read. Well, to be clear, I love books. And my goal in life is to read and speak about exceptional books. And for that, I explored many Indian books and then some books popularly picked by Indian readers. I experiment a lot. That also means I end up with many books that are below my expectations. But hey, this video is an exception because so far in 2024, I have had the pleasure of reading 5 non-fiction books and each of these come highly recommended and are quite popular. Let's delve into these valuable reads. But first, if you're not one of my 89,000 subscribers, please join my community today. Hit the bell button to turn on your notifications and treat yourself to some enriching bookish content. Now, book number one and my most recent read is Racket Boy by Philippe George with Geeta K. I read it in collaboration with the publisher and it's a memoir of this person who has his roots in India but was born in Malaysia and then chooses the immigrant life one more time as he moves to England and builds his life there from scratch. His love for sports, especially badminton, was a significant influence in this person's life. He played a lot of badminton throughout his life, which opened a lot of doors for him. I have done a full review of this book on the channel, which I'll link down below in the description. And yes, I gave it 4.5 out of 5 stars. Honestly, I was quite sure it would be a 3.5 to 4 star book for me, but it exceeded my expectations. I think what impressed the reader in me was the authenticity and simplicity of Philippe's entire life, which is on display in this book. Mind you, when I say simplicity, I'm just mentioning the way the story feels. It's just so authentic. It lacks unnecessary exaggeration and the masala, you know. But the writing and book are otherwise excellent. Philippe's story is just so interesting. If you're looking to read, but read to learn, you know, from other people's life and stories, you should check out this book. If you want to buy this book or any book mentioned in this video, the links are down below in the description. Next, I have a very short book called Keep Going by Austin Kleon. Actually, Austin Kleon has written 3 very famous short books, Steal Like an Artist, Show Your Work, and Keep Going. In my mind, these are short bursts of true motivation for artists and creative minds. You can read any of these 3 books in a single sitting, and the ideas and content of these books are really powerful. But I won't recommend you to buy the paperback versions of these books. They are just absurdly expensive in India. But hey, go for Kindle versions. They are available at almost half price compared to paperback versions. And anyway, if you're serious about reading books and changing your life with reading, just invest in a Kindle device. It offers a lot of flexibility as well as money-saving options for you as a reader. I'll drop a link to buy a Kindle down below in the description as well, so go for it. Anyway, coming back to Keep Going. You see what I did there? Anyway, the book is what I expected. It offers inspiration, it's a short read, but it's a good read, so yes, I loved it. Another book I hadn't expected to like this much is 11 Rules for Life by Chetan Bhagat. This is a non-fiction written by India's most famous fiction novelist, Chetan Bhagat. Now, Chetan isn't new to non-fiction. He has written several books of this kind before. This is more like the self-help one, and that is new, but nothing has been as authentic and as good so far as this particular book. In this book, Chetan has compiled 11 rules that can help you jump the class gap, become rich, powerful, and successful. I loved the way he delivered these rules and discussed them in the book. Again, I have done a dedicated video about this book, so do check it out. Now, Chetan Bhagat has become a powerful influencer. He shot to fame with his books and IIM and IIT background. Then he went on to become a judge in reality shows, which was a weird choice, honestly. Now, he's also an active YouTuber. But you know who's another very active YouTuber who has been writing non-fiction books? You may have seen one of his ads already for sure. Yes, Ankur Variku. Ankur Variku is one of the most famous and viral productivity gurus in the country. He has been writing books that I didn't get a chance to read, but recently he came out with Make Epic Money, which I picked up. Again, I have a dedicated video discussing Ankur's latest book. I've been putting up a lot of videos lately and I hope YouTube isn't hiding them from you. Hit the bell button to turn your notifications on if you want to catch all of my videos, or follow me on Instagram to catch daily stories. Link to my Instagram profile is down below in the description. Anyway, Make Epic Money. I think it's a decent read. It didn't have a lot of new stuff for me, and the book is very light on words, just short to the point things about money. I did like the section on health and life insurance, but other than that, the book was too basic for me given how much I already know about personal finance. Mind you, I'm still not the best at it. I think I need a dedicated book or coach to stop me from overspending or spending money like foolish people. But otherwise, I do feel like I have more knowledge about personal finance than regular people. I think anyone who chooses to invest time in reading will always have more knowledge than regular people and will do a little better in life even if they are inherently foolish or lack self-control like me. Those are my last words of wisdom before I move on to the last book that we are discussing in this video. Yes, I finally read Ikigai. Anytime you look at popular books in India, you will find Ikigai, the Japanese secret to a long and happy life. You can guess from the title what the book is about. I like it really. The studies and the facts mentioned about these tribes that enjoy long lives and what you can learn from them, it's all very good. But do you know what's my biggest concern? For how long such a book really stays with you? Like, I read it at the beginning of the year and I barely remember it now. All I remember are a few stories of the Japanese people and that's all. Did it change my life? Certainly not. That makes me wonder, what did I miss? Did I not read this correctly? Or are the people who claim Ikigai will change your life are just exaggerating? It's true, not every book can be life-changing for everyone, but when you read books, you expect to be moved and changed. Why is it that most of the modern books fail to do that? Whereas like the books that were written earlier are able to make that profound change more often, comparatively, you know. That's something to think about as I leave you with this video and list of nonfiction books that I read recently. I hope you enjoyed watching this video and do not forget to check out the description for the full book reviews and the links to buy these books. Thank you so much for watching this video. This is Manpreet signing off. I'll be back with another video very soon.